money, accommodation, and many other needs that they will need to endure throughout the year. So that was basically the purpose of the march. They came here to demand for answers in terms of why payments delayed until the 10th month of this. So we wanted answers in terms of that, when and how are those problems going to be resolved. And today we sit here at least very happy that we managed to sit with the management of NSFF yesterday, especially the CEO, and as a student leader organization with the various SRCs that came from the institution as well. We've managed to sit and deliberate on finding and mapping out the way forward that's in the best interest of the students, FNANSO, the institution, as well as NSFA itself. Yes, maybe just to give over in terms of the agreement.
Right, as you have heard from Simon, NANSO is very happy. The student representation is very, very happy about what we have managed to agree. So therefore, today, the 19th of October, we have agreed with NANSO on 4 points. And this is what we are going to implement from our side, and also some issues we are going to tackle them jointly. The first one is that we anticipate a transfer of $295 million from the Ministry of Finance to NSFAF. We expect that particular transfer process to be finalized by the 20th of October, which is tomorrow, Friday. And then we will use this money as follows. 100 million, we will assign that to the non-tuition fee. And we anticipate to start paying out that money between Monday the 23rd to Friday the 27th of October. And then 195 million will be assigned to tuition fees. To the institutions of higher learning, and we will be effecting payment from the 23rd of October to the 27th of October, and we hope now to finalize that. Now, however, the tuition fees, we may not pay the full amount, so we may pay 50% of the outstanding amount, with an understanding that we engage those institutions. Now, number two, we agreed that together, NSFAF together with NANSO and SRCs will engage the respective institutions of higher learning to allow the students to write examinations. Because that was the core issue, the reason why they decided to march is the concern that they may not be allowed to write examinations. Now, while we are effecting those payments, we will be jointly engaging those institutions to allow the students to write exams. Then number three, we will provide a list of pending awards because the award process is also not finalized. We have some 2,000 pending applications. 800 are kind of finalized, and by tomorrow we will make that list available to the institutions of higher learning. So that meaning that if the name of a particular applicant is appearing on that list, that person should be allowed also to sit for the examinations. And then we will then also issue the actual award letters of the 800 people between 23rd and the 27th of October 2017. And then finally, we also agreed that there's a list of 1,200 applicants that have submitted their applications, but they're pending some documentations, or mandatory documentations. We will give those people until tomorrow, the 20th, to submit the necessary documentations before we can close off. So if we don't receive them by tomorrow, we cut off. If we receive them, we look into it, and if they qualify, we will also submit that particular list. However, the list of the 1,200 will also make it available to NANSO, so that NANSO can maybe circulate it and then see if we can get those people to come and submit the necessary documentations. So that is where we are ending, or that is what we have agreed on. And now we would like to sign for this particular understanding. Thank you. Perhaps maybe we should allow questions if there are any. Otherwise, then we sign the document. Thank you.